Hello and welcome to the session on the topic Algebraic Systems with Two Binary Operations under the course Discrete Mathematical Structures at second year of Information Technology Engineering Semester 1. At the end of this session, students will be able to demonstrate ring, ring homomorphism, subring and field and its properties. These are the contents we are going to cover: ring, ring homomorphism, subring, field with its definition and examples. To start with, we'll see the definition for an algebraic structure termed as a ring. An algebraic system S, plus, dot is called a ring if the binary operation plus and dot on S satisfy the following three properties. Number one, S, plus is an abelian group. Number two, S, dot is a semigroup. And number three, the operation dot is distributive over plus. That is, for any A, B, C which belongs to S, we get A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C, and B plus C dot A is equal to B dot A plus C dot A. If you recollect, we have already defined the various other definitions such as semigroups, monoids, groups, abelian group, and so on. Using those definitions, now we come out with a new algebraic system called as ring, and this is defined on the basis of three properties. So let us discuss one by one. Number one condition says S, plus must be an abelian group. Now, when we consider the algebraic system S, plus, dot, we observe that unlike the earlier definitions, it contains an algebraic system with two binary operations. And which are these two operations? Namely, plus and dot. Now, based upon the context, each of plus and dot may have different meanings. Like, plus may be addition and dot may be multiplication. So, to start with, this algebraic system which contains the set S along with two binary operations. Number one, we define the algebraic system with single binary operation. First of all, S, plus must be an abelian group. Number two, when we assume the second binary operation being dot and construct the algebraic system S, dot, it must be a semigroup. And finally, coming to the distributive property, we say the operation plus must be distributed over by the operation dot. So that is why we get the condition. And if you observe, we have two different conditions to define where the operation dot gets distributed over the operation plus. In first case, A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. And when we interchange, that is B plus C dot A, it is not same as the earlier case, but it is equal to B dot A plus C dot A. And we know that A dot B is never same as B dot A, as well as A dot C is not same as C dot A. So here is a definition for a new algebraic system with two binary operations called as a ring. Let us assume certain examples to understand what is a ring. Here I have mentioned sets of integers, real numbers, rational numbers, even numbers, and complex numbers under the operations of addition and multiplication are familiar examples of rings. Now, if you observe each of these examples, let us say set of integers, we have assumed the two binary operations to be number one addition and number two multiplication. So if I say an algebraic system capital I, plus, dot, where capital I denotes sets of integers, plus denotes the operation of addition and dot the operation of multiplication, we can see that the three conditions which must be satisfied be to s comma plus comma dot to become a ring are satisfied. So that is why sets of integers I comma plus comma dot is said to be a ring. Likewise, we can easily prove the same result for the remaining sets I have mentioned here, that is sets of real numbers, sets of rational numbers, sets of even numbers and sets of complex numbers. Now, pause the video for a while and try to answer this question. What is a subring? If you recollect, in earlier videos, when we learnt about algebraic systems, we have learnt a group as well as a subgroup, a semigroup, a monoid, a sub-semigroup and a submonoid. And we have observed that all these sub-algebraic structures are based on the earlier defined algebraic structures, namely a subgroup is defined with the help of group, sub-semigroup is defined with the help of a semigroup, and submonoid is defined with the help of a monoid. Likewise, can you define a subring? As we all know, the definition for a ring now. Here is the answer. A subset R of set S, where S comma plus comma dot is a ring, is called a subring if the algebraic structure R comma plus comma dot is itself a ring with the operations plus and dot are restricted to R. Now, what do you mean by restricted to R is, simply when I perform addition of two numbers from the set R, the result also belongs to the same set R, as well as when I perform the operation of dot on any two elements from R, the result also belongs to the same set R. So based on the definition of ring, we have defined what is a subring. Here is one more definition, called as ring homomorphism. Let R comma plus comma dot and S comma star comma delta be two rings. A mapping G from R to S is called a ring homomorphism from R comma plus comma dot to S comma star comma delta if for any A comma B which belongs to R, we have two conditions. Number one, G of A plus B is equal to G of A into or star G of B, and G of A dot B is equal to G of A delta G of B. Now, each of these plus, dot, star and delta can be replaced by any operations under consideration. So, ring homomorphism is defined over two algebraic structures, namely rings, and then we define a mapping G from R to S, which is said to be ring homomorphism if it satisfies the given two conditions. The first condition is a group homomorphism from R comma plus to S comma star, while the second condition is a semi-group homomorphism from R comma dot to S comma delta. And here is the last definition for this session, called as field. A commutative ring S comma plus comma dot which has more than one element such that every non-zero element of S has a multiplicative inverse in S is called a field. So here is a definition which is again based on the earlier defined algebraic structure called as ring. We consider a commutative ring. Now what do you mean by commutative ring? I hope you remember. Each of the operations plus and dot are commutative in nature. So we define the ring S comma plus comma dot to be a commutative ring. And then we define that each of the element where every non-zero element of this particular algebraic structure S has a multiplicative inverse. Now, what is a multiplicative inverse? Where A dot A inverse is equal to the identity with respect to the operation dot. And that is also present in the same set S. Then that particular ring is given a special name as field. So what is the difference between a ring and a field? Is a ring is not a field, whereas a field, which will be always a ring containing the special property of having a multiplicative inverse for every non-zero element. With this, we have come to an end of the various algebraic structures with two binary operations. These are the references I have referred to. Thank you.